In my previous video, I showed you how to find keywords with less competition using Amazon's auto-suggestion. Today, we will explore 5 simple methods for doing Amazon KDP keyword research using Google. Let's get started. It comes as no surprise that Google is the most visited website. However, guess what? When people want to buy stuff online, they don't always start with Google. According to Statista, in 2022, only 26% of Italian shoppers searched for products on Google. The other 74% went straight to Amazon. Likewise, 68% of Spanish shoppers looked for products on Amazon's website, and 65% of German respondents did the same. And according to JungleScout's Consumer Trends Report of Q2 2022, over 60% of US online shoppers start their product search on Amazon. It is obvious that the number of people starting their product searches on Google is actually going down over time. After seeing all this data, you may wonder why I am making a video about how to do Amazon KDP keyword research using Google. First of all, you shouldn't underestimate the data Google has, which I will show you soon. In addition to this data, don't forget that Amazon listings still show up on Google. So if you optimize your listings for Google search results, you might get some free traffic from Google. At the start of the video, I mentioned that I will share 5 methods to do Amazon KDP keyword research using Google. The first method is Google suggested keywords. When you search using the Google bar, remember to use incognito mode. And if you are researching from a different country for another marketplace, make sure to adjust your language and region accordingly in the settings menu. Let's type graph paper notebook into Google search bar. Pay close attention to the autocomplete suggestions that appear. These suggestions are based on popular search queries related to your initial keyword. Keep in mind that Google users are often in discovery mode, seeking information and answers, like these ones. Therefore, focus on the suggestions that related to product features, such as graph paper notebook 8.5x11. If you watched my previous video on using Amazon auto-suggestion for KDP keyword research, you should be familiar with the alphabetical search technique. I mean, appending each letter of the alphabet to your search phrase. As usual, start with the letter A. Type graph paper notebook A. Take a screenshot of the autocomplete suggestions and record the related suggested keywords in an Excel sheet, just as I demonstrated in my previous video. Continue this process for letters B, C, and so on. The second method is checking the related searches section on Google search results page. Start by typing graph paper notebook into Google search bar. Google, assuming your intent is to make a purchase, will prioritize results from its shopping section. These results showcase products from various e-commerce companies, including Amazon. However, if you scroll down to the bottom of the page, you will find the related searches section. This section is where you can discover new keywords. For instance, if we click on the search phrase graph paper notebook Amazon and check the related searches section of this search phrase, for example, you will notice that some people search for large graph paper notebooks when looking to buy on Amazon. By narrowing down your search results like this, you might stumble upon low competition keywords that you hadn't considered before. The third method is checking the image search results. For instance, type graph paper notebook into search bar and hit search. This time, click on the images section. You will see a bunch of related terms displayed above the image results. Consider this area a hidden goldmine that Google provides, even though not many people talk about it. You can add these related keywords to your list. The fourth method of using Google for Amazon KDP keyword research is Google's Keyword Planner tool. Google's Keyword Planner is a free tool that provides estimated search volumes for any word or phrase. To access the Google Keyword Planner, you need to create a free AdWords account. Even though Google pushes you, you won't need to create any active campaigns or spend any money to use it. You can search on Google how to bypass it. Once you are logged in, on the left menu bar, click on the Tools and then select Keyword Planner under the Planning menu. You can start with the main keywords like graph paper notebook to get some keyword ideas. We have more than 600 keyword ideas. Then, on the right, you can refine keywords by filtering according to brand or non-brand. Let's exclude the store and branded searches. Now, we have fewer keywords. You don't need to check all. The most powerful feature of Google Keyword Planner is providing the search volumes. But notice that the search volumes you see on Google Keyword Planner do not equal the search volumes of Amazon. However, it will give you an idea and you can assume that the volume will be relatively similar. Furthermore, you can see here also the trend. This column shows the 3-month change in search trends by comparing the latest month's data with the data from the 2 months prior. Another way to use Google Keyword Planner is to discover keywords on a specific page. Yes, this can be an Amazon product page of your competitor too. You can simply copy the link to product page here and get the results. Again, like with search volume, these will not be the Amazon buyer keywords. Instead, they will be the keywords that Google finds on this product page. Most of them must be relevant, but as you can see, there is other product information as well on each product page, such as the compare with similar items section. So, Google Keyword Planner may show you some other brand's name as a keyword here. Therefore, to keep your account safe, you need to check the results one by one and pick only the relevant ones, recording them in your file. My final method for using Google to find Amazon KDP keywords is reverse engineering the products that are already ranked at the top of the Google search results. For instance, start by searching your targeted keyword on Google, like graph paper notebook, and check if any Amazon products appear in the top results. If you find one, click the link to understand why that specific product ranks so high on Google. For instance, you see some Amazon products in the shopping section. Examine the product pages for these items to gain insights. Additionally, pay attention to the Amazon link that appears at the top of the search results. Click on it and see if there is an Amazon KDP product on that page similar to the one you are interested in, like this one. Then analyze the product page carefully. Check if it is optimized not only for Amazon but also for Google. Check the ranking factors like product title, subtitle, pricing, publishing time, and overall product listing quality, such as having A+ content and high number of reviews. By carefully examining these factors, I'm sure you can find some valuable clues. Perhaps I should create a separate video dedicated solely to this topic. In today's video, I have shared 5 powerful methods for uncovering low competition keywords within your niche using Google. But guess what? This is just the beginning. In the upcoming videos of this Amazon KDP keyword research tutorial series, I will reveal even more free methods that you won't want to miss. So if you are serious about mastering KDP keyword research, hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. By doing so, you will be the first to know when I drop a new video. Thanks for watching. See you soon.